Last video, we discussed hardware architecture and functional building blocks of 8051 microcontroller. Let's see the pin details of 8051 microcontroller. So 8051 microcontroller is a 40-pin IC chip dual in line package. The 8051 has 32 I/O pins configured as 4 8-bit parallel ports. That is P0, P1, P2 and P3. All ports are bidirectional. Each port consists of a latch, an output driver and an input buffer. Let's see one by one. First, let's see pin number 1. That is pin number 1 to 8. Port 1. Port 1.0 to 1.7. Port 1 pins are used as input or output functions. Okay. So, port 1, pin number 1 to pin number 8 are used as input or output functions. Then, pin number 9, that is reset input. This pin is used to reset 8051 microcontroller. Whenever there is a high signal at this pin, 8051 enters into reset position. So that is the function of reset signal. Okay. Then pin number 10 to 17. Pin number 10 to 17, that is port 3 pins, port 3.0 to port 3.7. Port 3 act as a I/O ports and also it will do some alternate functions. They have some special functions. Port 3.0, that is pin number 10, act as serial input data, that is R cross D. Receive data. Okay. Receive data, the next one is transmit data, then interrupt 0, interrupt 1. Timer 0, timer 1, then write signal, then read signal. So, port 3.0 is nothing but serial input data. Port 3.1 is nothing but serial output data. Then port 3.2 act as external interrupt 0 input. Port 3.3 external interrupt 1 input. Port 3.4 external timer 0 input. Port 3.5 external timer 1 input. Port 3.6 external memory write signal. Then port 3.7 external memory read signal. So this is about port 3 functions. Then pin number 18 and 19, that is XTAL1 and XTAL2, that is crystal oscillator, is connected to a resonant network which generates clock pulses. The quartz crystal and capacitor combination can be used as a resonant circuit. Okay, then pin number 20, that is ground signal. It is nothing but VSS. This pin acts as return path. Then pin number 40, that is VCC. This pin acts as plus 5 volt power supply. So VSS is connected to ground and VCC is connected to plus 5 volt power supply. Then port 2, that is pin number 21 to pin number 28, port 2.0 to port 2.7. Port 2 are used to access external memory, which is also used to hold the high order address, that is A8 to A15. So port 2 is nothing but high order address lines. Then pin number 29, that is PSEN, that is program store enable signal. It is active as low output control signal, used to activate the enable signal of the external ROM or EEPROM memory. this pin is used to read the program code in the ROM memory. So that is the function of PSEN signal. Then pin number 30, that is ALE or PROG. ALE stands for address latch enable signal. The ALE signal is used to differentiate address and data in the multiplexed address data bus. If it is low, the data on the data bus indicates the data, otherwise it represents the lower order address. So that is the function of ALE. Then pin number 31, that is EA bar, that is external access. This is active as low signal. When EA pin is high, that is connected to VCC, program fetches to address 0000 or directed to the internal ROM memory. When EA pin is active as low, that is connected to ground, program fetches to address 1000 through FFFF or directed to external ROM or EEPROM memory. Then pin number 32 to 39, that is 40.0 to 40.7. 40 is used for both address and data bus, that is AD0 to AD7, multiplexed address data lines. 40 are used to access external memory. Here ALE pin is used to indicate if port 0 has address or data. When ALE is equal to 0, port 0 provides data, that is D0 to D7. Suppose ALE is equal to 1, port 0 provides address, that is A0 to A7. So these are the details of pin diagram of 8051 microcontroller. The next topic is memory organization of 8051 microcontroller. The total memory of an 8051 system is logically divided into two memory sections. The first one, program memory. Second one, data memory. Let's see the first type, program memory. Program memory, that is ROM type, shows the program to be executed. The program memory may be categorized as on-chip, that is internal and external memory, depending upon whether the memory physically exists on the chip or it is externally interfaced. The 8051 can address 4 kilobytes of on-chip program memory, whose map starts from 4 zeros to 0FFF. It can address 64 kilobytes of external program memory under the control of PSEN signal, whose address map is from 0000 to FFFF. Thus, the internal program memory overlaps with that of the external program memory. These two memory spaces can be distinguished using PSEN signal. Okay. See the internal memory address, starting address, 4 zeros, ending address, 0FFF. Similarly, external memory, starting address, 4 zeros to 0FFF. Same address is used for both internal and external memory. Using PSEN signal, the controller access whether internal memory or external memory. If EA signal is active as high means that time the controller access the internal memory. If the EA signal is active as low means that time the controller access the external memory with the help of PSEN signal. The next one is data memory. Data memory stores the data like the immediate result, variables and a constant required for the execution of the program. Then internal memory, the 8051
has a hardware architecture which uses the separate code or program memory and data memory. The 8051 has internal RAM and ROM memory for these functions. Additional memory can be added externally using suitable circuits. Let's see the internal RAM organization. So this is the diagram for internal RAM organization. It contains 128 bytes internal RAM is organized into three groups. The first 32 bytes from address 00 to 1F is organized as four banks of 8 registers R0 to R7 each, totally gives 32 working registers. The four register banks are numbered 0 to 3. Bits RS0 and RS1 on the PSW, that is processor status word, determine which bank of registers is currently in use at any time when the program is running. A register banks not selected can be used as a general purpose RAM. Bank 0 is selected on reset. The next 16 bytes, that is address 20 to TO2 2F, okay, is the bit addressable area, forming a total of 128 addressable bits. An addressable bit may be specified by its bit address of 00 to 7F. The general purpose RAM area, that is starting address 30 to ending address 7F, addressable as bytes. Like that, the internal memory can be categorized 32 bytes, bank registers, then bit addressable area, then general purpose registers. Okay. Then the next one is stack. The stack is an area of the internal RAM which is used in conjunction with the certain opcodes to store and retrieve data quickly. The stack is limited in height to the size of the internal RAM. The stack is normally placed high in internal RAM by an appropriate choice of the number placed in the stack pointer register to avoid conflict with the register bit and scratch pad internal RAM areas. The 8051 stack is not a top-down data structure like other Intel processors. So the stack pointer is a memory pointer which is used by the 8051 to hold an internal RAM address, that is called the top of the stack. After reset, the stack pointer register is initialized to 07. Then internal ROM. So the 8051 has 4 kilobytes of ROM from 00, 00 to 0F, FF. The 8051 is organized so that the data memory and the program code memory can be into two entirely different physical memory entries. Each has the same address ranges. Program address higher than 0FFF will cause the 8051 to automatically fetch code bytes from external program memory. Then external memory. The system designer is not limited by the amount of internal RAM and ROM available on chip. So two separate external memory spaces are made available by the 16-bit program counter and data pointer. External RAM is needed when 128 bytes of internal data storage is not sufficient. External RAM up to 64 kilobytes may be added to any chip in the 8051 family using 62-864 type chip. Then the ROM may be expanded to 64 kilobytes using 27512 type EEPROM. External ROM is accessed whenever external access, that is EA pin, is connected to ground, or when the PC contains an address higher than the last address in the internal 4 kilobyte of ROM, that is 0FFF. Thus, 8051 can use internal and external ROM automatically. So this is about memory organization of 8051 microcontroller.